When Myrtle Beach, South Carolina is brought up in conversation, baseball may not be the first thing that comes to mind, but since 1999, the Myrtle Beach Pelicans, the Texas Rangers Class Advanced A affiliate, have been one of the city's top attractions. The Pelicans were originally the Durham Bulls from 1980 to 1997. Major League Baseball's expansion to Tampa Bay, however, forced the franchise to relocate. It was the prime opportunity to have baseball in the Grand Strand, and after an initial struggle, the city came together to bring the team to Myrtle Beach.
Well, at the time, I was the chairman of Horry County Council, and there was a push to bring Major League Baseball to Horry County in the Grand Strand. There had been some attempts in the past by several individuals to bring it here, and it was somewhat successful, but it never really panned out. Capital Broadcasting was the owner of the Durham Bulls and had to leave and find a new home. So they chose Myrtle Beach. It was a Atlanta Braves affiliation, which made it all the more intriguing for us here because the Atlanta Braves were sort of a hometown team because we didn't have a major league team in South Carolina, North Carolina. The city came to us and the county, and we tried to put something together. And after a long battle, we were able to build this fine stadium.
Coastal Federal Field, the team's new home, opened in 1999.
And there was some skepticism at first from a lot of different people. There was people who didn't want to use public funds and public monies to build a facility, but we thought that once we had the facility built and the team was in place, that the locals would rally around it and start attending as well as the tourists, and that's exactly what's done.
Marcus Giles was the star player in the team's inaugural season, leading the Carolina League with a .326 batting average, 162 hits, and 40 doubles. Later that season, Giles was joined by his co-star, Rafael Furcal. In just 43 games with the Pelicans, Furcal batted .293 with 54 hits, 9 of them doubles, and stole 23 bases.
For all of us here, it was exciting. They kind of floundered, I would say, in the first half, but they brought this young fella up by the name of Furcal and put him in the infield next to Marcus Giles, and that seemed to have changed the whole texture of the ball club around.
The dynamic duo of Giles and Furcal helped lead the franchise to the Mills Cup final against the Wilmington Blue Rocks. The Pelicans and the Blue Rocks were tied at 2 games apiece in the best of 5 series, but before the two teams could play the deciding game, Hurricane Floyd arrived and devastated the North Carolina coast. In light of the natural disaster, the two teams are crowned co-champions. The next season, the Pelicans rode an 88-52 record back to the Mills Cup final and won the Mills Cup for the second consecutive season. The team accomplished this feat without the help of either Giles or Furcal, with Furcal making his MLB debut for the Braves at the beginning of the 2000 season. Furcal's number 2 was retired by the Pelicans in 2001. From 1999 to 2010, the development of players in Myrtle Beach helped the Atlanta Braves win 7 National League East titles and make the playoffs 8 times. Some notable Major League stars who spent time developing in Myrtle Beach include Brian McCann, Jeff Francoeur, Elvis Andrews, Neftali Feliz, Matt Harrison, Freddie Freeman, Jason Hayward, and Jared Saltalamacchia. Outside of baseball, the organization was also undergoing an evolution. In 2006, Chuck Greenberg bought the Pelicans, and the team debuted a new logo, new color scheme, and new uniforms. In 2007, the Pelicans installed a state-of-the-art video board and ribbon board and built a beach adjacent to the bullpen on the third base side. The beach is one of the most unique ballpark features in all of minor league baseball.
If you go down that left field line up on the concourse, that used to be a berm. And people could come to the ballpark, take a blanket or whatever it is, and they would sit up on the berm and watch the ball game.
On September 17th, 2010, the Atlanta Braves signed a new agreement with the Lynchburg Hillcats, ending an 11-year relationship with the Myrtle Beach Pelicans. That same day, the Texas Rangers announced they would partner with Myrtle Beach. From 2011 through 2013, Robbie Ross, Mike Ault, and Nick Tepish developed their talents in the Grand Strand and made their major league debuts with the Rangers. Current Rangers top prospect Rougned Odor has continued down the same road of success that Rafael Furcal paved for so many players back in 1999. Throughout the team's history, the Pelicans have not only been a popular tourist attraction, but most importantly, something the local community has wholly embraced.
A lot of times the city and the county didn't really get along on a lot of different issues, but this issue we came together. It was a concerted effort by a lot of people, and this is what we have to show for it. The stadium is great, the team's great, and I couldn't be more pleased with the way it turned out.